Hello everyone and welcome to a very special convention on social responsibility, Behtar India. We are in Kolkata. Well, Behtar India is a path-breaking, innovative and a completely unique campaign involving citizens, corporates and school children, people from all walks of life. NDTV, in partnership with DHFL Pramerica Life Insurance Company Limited, has launched this brand new campaign, a 360-degree campaign, which has three pillars: Swasthya, Swachhata, and Vatavaran. Well, we are in Kolkata, the city of joy. It has a rich heritage to boast of, but unfortunately, this city of joy is crying for help. The heritage structures are crumbling. The infrastructure needs upgradation. The government health services are under tremendous pressure. The unruly traffic and the open garbage dumps that you see everywhere. If you all work together, we can make difficult tasks achievable. So let's all work together to make a Behtar Kolkata and a Behtar India. Well, at this point, I would like to call on stage with me Major Suvan Majumdar, AVP and National Product Manager, DHFL Pramerica Life Insurance Company Limited. Thank you so much. Please join us on the panel, Major Suvan Majumdar. In fact, before I call my other distinguished guests on the panel, just a quick reaction from all of you seated here, the children from various schools who've joined us for this convention today. What, according to you, I want to ask you, what, according to you, are the issues in your city?
The most important issue which I feel needs to be solved in Kolkata is garbage disposal. Whenever I walk onto the streets, I find loads of garbage which is thrown, but that is not a big issue. The garbage which is collected there is again dumped on the Dakshineshwar Expressway, which is faced by all of us, and when it is burned, it causes air pollution too, which is claiming a life every 23 seconds in India.
Very good observation and very good points that you have suggested.
I believe the core problem of, may it be women empowerment, pollution, garbage disposal, is the mindset of the people of India. If we're able to change the working of the people of India, their minds, then everyone would work to towards a Behtar India.
Excellent. Excellent points made by the students. And in fact, we'll come back to you for more concerns that you have with regards to your city. Joining Major Suman Majumdar on the panel is Mr. Hemant Kanoria. So please come. Chairman and Managing Director, Sri Infrastructure Finance Limited. Also joining us on the panel, Renu Kakkar. She's Director CSR, APJ Surendra Group. And Mr. Sanjay Agarwal, MD Century Ply. So please come up. And also with us is Mrs. Sangeeta Thakral. She's Head Communication and Marketing, Charities Aid Foundation, CAF. Charities Aid Foundation is also the implementation partner of Behtar India, our campaign. So she's in touch with all the ground realities when it comes to implementing a project. Mr. Kanoria, if I could start with you first. At the ground level, when we bring in children to bring about a change, what kind of an impact does it have? And what do you make of Behtar India?
In India, our culture has always been that how does a corporate contribute to society? Because everyone in the corporate, which is responsible, they are right from the beginning, it is ingrained in their minds. Like I remember as a small child, that it was always ingrained in my mind, my grandfather and father, that whatever you do, and if you have wealth, you are custodians. So therefore, whatever you are contributing to society, to that measure, only you should be in a position to use it for yourself, and balance should be redeployed back into business because it goes back to society. So that has been ingrained. Now, after the government came out with the CSR norms and said the corporates will have to do that and put a structure in place, so it is good because, you know, many of the corporates were doing it right since the beginning of their lives. But when the corporate world has now put a structure in place, it gives a lot of opportunity for collaborating, for doing it at a much larger scale, in a more structured manner. So I think that this is something which is greatly affected the whole corporate world.
Ma'am, your conglomerate focuses on individual social responsibility. Now, that is something unique and different. One doesn't hear of it. Can you just elaborate on that?
It started with a very small thing. I had volunteered for an NGO to make their citizenship awareness program in Bangalore. And they gave me a certificate, which is just a ribbon of honor. So when I did receive it, the first thing I did was I went back to my boss, who's the chairman of the APG Surendra Group, Mr. Karan Paul. And I told him I was so happy about it that, you know, it was better than any promotion he had ever given me. So he says, why don't you extend it to the 43,000 people in APJ? Let's look at a concept. So within a month's time, I had created this concept of individual social responsibility. I presented to the board of directors and it was admitted. Now, one of the key things about that concept is that within the week, in office hours, when the NGO needs an employee, it's a skill program.
Mr. Agarwal, Century Ply, your company is doing a lot of work in the environment space. Now, I was also reading that your company is also targeted planting about 1 lakh trees all across West Bengal to tackle the problem of global warming. How difficult a task is that?
See, as far as tree plantation is concerned, it's actually, you can say, a part of our business, because we have used the forests earlier. Of course, after 1996, you can't cut a tree in India anymore. So there is a kind of a responsibility in our mind that we should and we must plant trees. So every year, for so many years, we have been trying to do something as far as the plantation of trees is concerned. But I tell you, as simple a task as planting the tree is so difficult.
Sangeeta, CAF, Charity's Aid Foundation, now is the implementation partner for Behtar India. Why did you feel the need to associate with Behtar India?
When I heard about this campaign, it had the perfect element of collaboration. The ideas where CAF India is based on, if you look at our vision statement, we say that we are here to create a society, a culture of giving in our society. However, as an organization, when I say that we are trying to bring that culture of change, we want people to give more towards strategic, purposes. And when I look at this campaign, it has the students involved in the entire campaign, and students are the ambassadors of this campaign, which means it has to start from that level. It's a complete paradigm shift that we are looking at. And it is a responsibility of all corporates to now come together and support this.
I would like to ask you now, talking about city of Calcutta, okay, city of joy, but there are too many issues that one needs to look into. It needs a collaborative approach. Okay. The volunteering doesn't happen as much as it should.
Right.
How are you going to ensure that people volunteer and do their bit to make this a better place?
Right, perfect. Guys, you know, I have always thought about Calcutta. I haven't spent too much time in Calcutta. I've just been on and off sometime during vacations when I was a kid, when I was growing up, right? But I realized one thing about Calcutta is that the bonding is very strong, okay? You can go to any other city which may be a little more cleaner, it may have a better infrastructure, but this bonding which is there in Calcutta is not there anywhere, guys. In a group of 10 people, where you trust people, if somebody comes and tells you, okay, let's do this, it generally does get, it materializes, okay? That's volunteering. It's already happening in your city, okay? What we need to now look at is how do we change the direction and make sure that it is not only for our spiritual self, it is also for our practical self also.
Mr. Kanodia, your conglomerate has diversified into many areas as far as corporate social responsibility is concerned. You look at it as a social investment, but I want to ask you that there are other corporates which are probably just involved in ad hoc initiatives and not seeing it as an investment. Why do you think that is happening, and what should be done to change this?
No, I think that the point which you mentioned very rightly was that, how can corporates collaborate together? Because someone may take up an initiative and someone may be really driven into that initiative from their heart and their mind.
True.
So therefore, that initiative should become a part, and it will be for that corporate also to see that how they can involve other people.
Isn't it a fact, ma'am, that if different companies come together, they come with different expertise, they come with different skill sets, and that, of course, will lead to large-scale social transformation. So this should be something that should be uppermost in everyone's minds right now.
When you talk about actual collaboration, I can give you an example, maybe not from Calcutta. You know that humans take too much space. We take too much space in cities, we take so much space everywhere. So we've taken almost all the space of animals in their habitats as well. So in Assam, we have a huge issue of
elephant-human conflict.
We've invested in the mitigation of the human-elephant conflict in Assam. Now comes the point of collaboration. So are we the only plantations in that area that we are doing? We are doing in the district of Sonitpur. Mm-hmm. We've got WWF India as our implementation partner. We are not the only, we've only got 4 plantations in that entire area in Sonitpur. There are other companies who are in neighboring us who have the similar human-elephant conflict issues. So what we have done, we've not invested in a project that is coming for our 4 plantations, but we are invested in this project for the entire North Bank landscape.
When you work on the ground, what has been your personal experience? Getting support from government agencies, isn't that a difficult task too? Because do we have mechanisms in place, the right mechanisms in place for the government agencies to also come on board?
So, yes, all the government agencies are there. But I believe that there needs to be some kind of a policy. I will give you an example. When I come out of my house, I see many schools. But most of them I find, if it is being run by a society, it is doing wonderful.
I see.
If it's run by an individual, it is doing wonderful. But if it is run by government, by the local municipality, then you find that there are no teachers, there is no quality, there are no students. Why? So I believe that, yes, this is one area. A lot of collaboration is happening, but this is one area where a government and private CSR people can collaborate is some kind of a policy is required, actually.
I think it is important for someone to drive this collaboration. When you say collaboration, these are all disintegrated, you know, hubs here and there. Somebody has to drive it. And as far as government is concerned, government is very cognizant of the fact, and that is the reason why you see all these campaigns. So that is already, a platform has already been provided by government. And then all the stakeholders come forward and support that. One way of doing it is that. The other way of doing it is forums like this, where NDTV and, you know, somebody coming together and launching a campaign where you give another platform for, you know, corporates or multi-stakeholder involvement. As far as NGOs on the ground level is concerned, it is extremely crucial because they have the first-hand experience. They know what is the community requires.
Exactly.
Where are the linkages, what needs to be done, and also about the outcome that is expected by the community on the ground.
Isn't it difficult for companies to collaborate sometimes because, you know, they face political hurdles, they face economic hurdles, and sometimes it's just not easy to get everyone on board with one common strategy. It's just not possible.
So I think that, as you mentioned about the mindset, that is the first mindset change that we have to do, that, you know, when you start off and you embark on something which is good, there would be a lot of resistance.
Yes.
Very many people will not collaborate. But you have to have that conviction that if I start on this, I will get people to come. And whether people come or don't come along with me, we are going to make it happen. And I think that is the first mindset change, because we want the other people to do something and then we'll follow it. Why can't we take the leadership?